Splicing animal DNA has become quite a hobby, and as you've been asking, I've taken my frog here to my laboratory at home and spliced his DNA using crude equipment with an owl egg. Here it is heating up my lab. When the owl hatched from his egg, it was no longer an owl, but a frog owl. This creature was far more dangerous than I had expected, and I needed gloves and a full suit to handle him. I set him free, but he kept returning to my home. Look at his eyes. This creature is one of the most amazing things I've ever created. Thanks for watching. Follow for part 2.
Growing up, my two favorite animals were always dogs and frogs. I always wanted to combine them to make a hybrid frog dog. With a little help from my chemistry professor, that is exactly what I did.
Frog DNA and dog DNA splice perfectly together. And as you can see, they're perfectly healthy and happy. They're so happy and they love to hop around. They're so fun. I love these little guys. One of the best parts about all of this is I have been able to give hundreds of dog frogs to loving families who have taken care of them and given them happy, hoppy homes. Nothing new is sweeter than with you. And in the street we run a free like it's only you and me. Jeez, you got something to see. Oh, let me go home. I've always loved chipmunks, and so I wanted to make a new creature out of chipmunk DNA. And so I extracted some from my pet chipmunk here. And I'm sure you are all well aware of my pet pig here. His DNA helped in the process of splicing their DNA in my home laboratory. This process was easier than you may think. I had to bottle feed them as babies growing up. And here they are in their incubator. As you can see, they look like pigs, but they have fur like chipmunks. They are very small. This one is full grown. They only grow about 10 pounds. They are so cute. Follow for part 2.
I always wanted to mix the DNA of an insect with a mammal. And that is exactly what I did when I took this pill bug and I extracted its DNA and mixed it with a mole. What's so interesting about this animal is that it's not only an insect, but it's also a mammal. The results were astounding. As you can see, the mole developed a bright white fur, but retained its armor. This beautiful creature is on the market right now for $20,000.
I wanted to create something extremely strange, and so I took DNA from one of my pet jellyfish here and spliced it with DNA from my pet pig. You all know who this is. I took their DNA samples to my laboratory and ran some experiments, and it turns out that they were compatible. You will not believe what this thing looks like. This amazing creature is always moist, and it can breathe air, but loves to be in the water. I love this little thing so much. I've made about 500 of them so far. Thanks for watching. Bye. This is one of my most amazing creations yet. It started with DNA from my pet kangaroo here, which I spliced with DNA from my bunny chicken hybrid from my earlier video. I took their DNA to my home laboratory, quickly fertilized an egg, and after about 5 months, my eggs were ready to hatch. This kangaroo bunny hybrid is one of a kind. As you can see, it's kept its bunny-like features with its fur and ears, but has a kangaroo face. This is one of my most amazing creations yet. Please follow for part 2. Thank you. Bye.